Looky here. I am reborn from the fires of destruction. Just like the phoenix.
Hold it!
Not that phoenix!
The phoenix is one of the most iconic mythological creatures out there. Versions of it appear in numerous cultures, and the bird has entered popular consciousness as a symbol of rebirth. For those of you living under a rock who have somehow avoided learning anything about this creature, the phoenix is usually portrayed as a bird, commonly a raptor of some kind like a hawk or an eagle, that, at the end of its life, dies a fiery death and is reborn from the ashes. Because of this, the phoenix is usually portrayed with red and gold feathers. The origins of the phoenix myth are somewhat difficult to identify, as versions of the myth appear in numerous cultures throughout history. The phoenix has a long tradition in China, where it is called Fin Wang and represents the southern direction. In Japan, a version of the Fin Wang appears as the Ho-O, that is, the males were identified as Ho and the females as O. If that sounds familiar, it's probably because you're familiar with Pokemon and the legendary bird Ho-O. The versions that eventually became the modern Western phoenix, however, were present mostly in Egypt and Persia. In Egypt, the phoenix was called Bennu, and it took the form of a heron with a crown. The Bennu symbolized three things in Egyptian culture. The first was creation. As herons stood in the waters of the flooded Nile, their long legs making it seem almost as if they were rising from the water, it was believed that the Bennu was the first creature to appear in the world during creation. Secondly, the Bennu symbolized the god Osiris, Lord of the Dead, who was killed by his brother Set, but was put back together by his wife Isis, and raised from death. Finally, the Bennu symbolized the sun. The bird was heavily associated with Heliopolis, the city of the sun, and the word Bennu is believed to come from the word weben, which translates to shine or rise. Association with the sun is a common theme among phoenixes. In Persia, the phoenix was called Huma, or bird of paradise. As with the Bennu, the Huma was connected with the sun, even to the point of also being linked to Heliopolis. There was only ever one Huma in the world at a time. Every 500 years or so, the bird would sense its death coming and build a nest. Then, with the rising sun, it would burst into flames and be reborn from the ashes. The bird then gathered the ash into an egg, which it took to Heliopolis and deposited at the altar of the sun god. It's not really that hard to see the connection with the sun. Even in ancient times, the sun was seen as a ball of fire, and of course, there's the rather obvious fact that both birds and the sun are present in the sky. The sun sets at the end of every day and rises at the start of the next day. It is an endless cycle of rebirth, just like the phoenix. The term phoenix itself comes from Greek. As was common among ancient societies, the myths sort of blended together. Heliopolis, which features in the lore of both the Bennu and the Huma, is, of course, Greek. And Greece adapted the Bennu and Huma into its own mythology as a single bird. The phoenix. This is where the modern interpretation of the phoenix derives from. More versions of the phoenix appear in other mythologies. The Garuda of Hinduism and Buddhism is often identified as a phoenix, for example. And then there's the Russian firebird, who you may recognize from the Firebird Suite and the beautiful interpretation of it in Fantasia 2000. It should be noted, however, that the firebird of the original Russian tale has little resemblance to the traditional phoenix, other than being a bird who glows. The Russian fairy tale also exists in other forms. I believe the Brothers Grimm recorded it as the Golden Bird. Read it if you ever get a chance. It's basically a big fantastic quest story. The phoenix also exists in Judaic tradition, where it is called Hul. This has led to some confusion as to whether the phoenix truly ever existed in scripture, however, as Hul can also be translated as sand. And certain passages referring to the bird could also be referring to sand. For example, in the book of Job, "Then I said, I shall die in my nest and multiply my days as the hull." In this context, both translations make sense. According to the French rabbi who called himself Rashi, however, the hull was in fact a bird. The story goes that when Eve ate the fruit of knowledge, she shared it with all the animals of the garden, and only the hull refused to eat it. As such, death has no hold on the bird. These tales and passages naturally found their way to Christianity, and many Christians used the hull to justify their belief in the phoenix. With this adaptation of the phoenix myth, also came yet another interpretation of its symbolism. Now, this one's pretty much a no-brainer. The phoenix is an animal that rises from death. It shouldn't take a genius to figure out what Christians would associate that with. With the spread of Christianity and the Catholic Church, the phoenix was reinterpreted as a metaphor for Jesus Christ, his death, his resurrection on the third day, and his immortality. The phoenix has since become a popular folkloric beast. Shakespeare employed references to the phoenix in a number of his plays, including The Tempest, and more recently, Fox from J.K. Rowling's insanely popular Harry Potter series, has ensured that the phoenix will live on in the minds of a whole new generation.
The phoenix is a beast that defies death. It is a cycle of endless life, death, and resurrection. It is a beast born of calamity. It is rebirth. It is the sun. It is Christ. It is a big freaking bird that occasionally bursts into flames. It is the